Hello guys, my name is Galton and I'm here to teach you about volumes. Welcome to my new tutorial on volume calculation. So firstly, we have the two data that you want to use, the after x coefficient and the before x coefficient data. So let me go to reset. So I've taught you from the previous videos on how to digitize a string and how to create a DTM. As a recap, we are going to do it again, but in this time, firstly, we create a new layer. I'm going to name it limit, then you apply. Then in that new layer, we are using the after string so that we digitize the after string. We want to digitize the limit for the volume calculations, the area that you want to, they want the volume calculation, the volume to be calculated from. So we go to create, then I say digitize properties. I want string number 8. Then I apply. Then I go to snap, then I say snap to point. Then I go to create, digitize new point. Then I start from here. I'm going to use this line is my limit. So following this line, digitizing, snapping to a point. I'm going to be a bit faster so that we can finish in time. So undo here. I want to follow that line only. Create, going to create, digitize new point again. Then it continues. Then continue following the line. I'll continue following the line. I want the outer one. Create digitize new points. Then from there, I go to close the digitizing. Then I say save, apply. If I close this one, make it invisible, you will see that this is the area that I have digitized. Then I go to reset. Then again, I drag the after, bring it up. Then I go to surfaces, create. You have to create a DTM so that you can calculate the volume. So in this case, I'm going to use string number 5, object ID number 5 for this one. Then I apply. Then for save, then I save it. I put the 5 extension, the one that I used for ID, so that I can easily identify it in the future when I want to use it. Then I apply. Then I have already done that for the before one. So these are our two strings that we have, the two DTMs that we have. Now let's go to, now we are now teaching you how to calculate the volume. Go to surfaces, then you have volume. You have two methods of calculating volume. Either you use the cut and fill method or the net volume between method. I'm going to use the net volume between first, then the cut and fill later. So here, from two DTMs, the upper and lower DTMs. The before is going to be my upper DTM, then object ID. Remember the two that I have put before on the after the before, so that I know which object ID I used. Then two, because if you use the wrong object ID, it won't calculate. Then here, 5, after 5. If you change any of these object ID, it won't calculate. Always remember that. So now I have my string limit. My limit is string number 8. And then I put 8 here. Decimal places. Then I choose the density for my rock. My rock density is 2.7, 2.6 for this one, sorry. Then I apply. Then the PDF that I'll have, then I'll say net, let's say volume. That's my first one. Either you can save it as a note, CSV, or whatever you want, but for me, I want to save it as a PDF. Then I apply. Then I apply, apply. Then it's now processing. Then it's done. volume between DTMs, this is our horizontal net volume. The surface is volume 4411.055. Net tonnage, when you are using the density of 2.6, you get this one, 11,468.742. That's our volume. Let me minimize this one. Again, you can do the same way. You go back to surfaces. I want to teach you how to use the cut at few methods. Then you go to, again, before, to apply, then object ID 2. Then I go here, after, open object ID number 5. Remember the extension. Then the boundary string was number 8. This one is correct. You just go here, select the limit, open boundary number 8. Again, location limit, open boundary string number 8. Density, again, 2.6. What kind of file I want in this case, let me use not, so that you can see how comes out when it's a knot. Then I apply. Yes. There we go. This is our volume from the DTM. We have the cut view volume. This is our volume. Let me make it a bit bigger so that you can see. Okay. Net volume we have 4463.22. This is our cut volume. Net volume, this is our net volume. You might have it as a negative or a positive depending on which, how I have put the information, the net tonnage. If you put the other DTM or vice versa, the DTMs, you'll find it will give you a negative. But let's us compare it with the one we had from the first one, this one. We have 4411.055. Let's check on the note. We have 441. The difference is in the range. Okay, thanks guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed that. And make sure to like and subscribe to my videos and channel. Thank you very much, guys.